Mayor Bill de Blasio infuriated New York City parents on Wednesday when he abruptly shut down public schools over rising COVID infection rates. If they still have jobs, working parents now have to scramble just to figure out childcare. And of course, there's the technology for virtual learning. But there is an estimated 60,000 kids who cannot immediately pick up with online lessons. They are still waiting for devices to be provided to them by the city. And for others, getting a computer won't help. They don't have access to Wi-Fi. Geoffrey Canada is joining me now. He is the founder of Harlem Children's Zone and appeared in the film Waiting for Superman. And Mr. Geoffrey Canada, it is an honor and a privilege to have you on. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Brooke. It's really a pleasure for me to be on. And I'm so happy you've decided that you want to talk about this issue.
Of course I want to talk about this issue, and you were the person I want to talk about the issue with. You know, I know you're calling this an educational disaster, especially for underprivileged kids. What can we do about it?
Well, this is the issue. We've never had anything like this happen before. You've got young people growing up afraid to be near anybody, afraid they're going to kill their grandparents, no friends, no education. And on top of that, this very same families, they've lost their jobs. They don't know how they're going to get food. They're worried about being evicted from their apartments. And this hasn't been going on for a month or two. This has been going on for 7-8 months. This is the kind of trauma that children in America have never faced before. And I feel like I'm the lookout on the Titanic yelling, hey, there's an iceberg, and no one's listening. So what do we need to do? I am calling for our teachers to be vaccinated right after we do the healthcare workers, because we've got to get these schools open. We've got to give our kids the health, the mental health, the support they need, and get their education back on track. But we need more than just to open the schools. We've got to rethink education, where we're providing a comprehensive set of supports to these children, because we've recognized this is not just one challenge in poor communities. It's challenge after challenge after challenge, and schools can't do it by themselves. So we need to rethink how schools operate in terms of the total community.
Tell me more about that. What do you mean, total community?
I think there are a bunch of us who believe you've got to do a cradle to career strategy. You've got to start with families literally at birth and surround them with the best practice in education. You've got to make sure young people have the best in-school support, after-school support, weekend support, summer support, and they get health services, and they get mental health services, and we give them sports and exercise. That's what we do at the Harlem Children's Zone. There are other places around this country who are doing that kind of a program, and it's all centered around helping kids be successful in schools. This is not just dumping this on schools and saying, hey, teachers and principals, you saw 50 years of disinvestment in this community by having the kid a few hours.
Quick last question. I want to squeeze this in. You know, parents, I know your mom was integral for you in terms of handing you books at a young age when you grew up with not a whole heck of a lot in the South Bronx. You know, and there are parents out there struggling. A lot of them, you know, don't have jobs, trying to get a roof over the head, don't have access to Wi-Fi. What do you tell parents right now? 30 seconds.
So here's the message to parents. Look, don't give up. We have help coming. There's going to be a vaccination. We're going to get these schools back open. A bunch of us are trying to think about how we can help and support you. But you have to be honest with your children. They know you're struggling. Don't be afraid to sit and talk to them and explain why it's tough, but explain that things are going to get better. We're going to go out and do everything humanly possible to help the poorest families in this country.
Bless you. Geoffrey Canada, thank you so much. Thank you. President Trump's...